Commissioners, we'd like to go ahead and get y'all's approval. Let Stephanie go through her financial report. It will be kind of a summation of what you've heard, so we won't delve into as much unless you like to, but it is kind of a calculation of the 2 minutes that you've already heard. So.
I won't go over the first sections of this. This is, you've gotten this information before in other presentations, but just as a reminder of how things are accounted for, you have 5 different types of funds and multiple funds within each of those types, and they are accounted for differently depending on what type of fund they are. Those funds don't commingle for the most part. They're for specific purposes, so your main operations are part of the general fund. Some of those are business-like, some of them are governmental.
Mr. Page, you wanted to know about the special revenue funds. There's a breakdown, page 4.
Okay.
There's a complete list of all of those. We had referenced earlier, and we'd be going through that, so I want to just highlight them.
I'm down with the class, right?
But there's a listing of all the funds that are included in each type of fund on those couple of pages there. You see what the capital projects funds are, and just a few highlights about each one, or the type of fund. If you skip over to page 9, talks about cash flows. We have a true cash fund and we have segregated cash funds for those that can't be commingled. Cash flow usually becomes strained around the middle of the calendar year when new budget starts, because those revenues generally, the bulk of our revenues generally don't come until November or December. We also have some issues with some of those revenues declining, and with the SPLOST declining the way it was, and having to use general fund monies to fund the SPLOST projects, and also some of those other funds from the deficit. The earlier presentation heard how all those affect the general fund. So for a couple of years, we actually asked you to fund the 10 to make it sure to cash flow through the end of the year. We don't anticipate even using or even getting a chance. If you got one the year before last and never used it, we've not gotten one the last year.
And there's no cost to the 10 if we get it but don't use it.
Right, there's no cost if we don't use it.
Right, that's exactly right. Credit line. It's a little bit bigger than we most of the time.
Millage, I know this sounds totally backwards, but when we do our budget, we have to anticipate what our tax revenues are going to be. You will not get a digest from the assessor's office until after your budget is approved. And then you have to back into making sure that you've covered your revenue estimations and done what the commission wants as far as millage goes, whether you lose the same rate or lower. We have to try to make all that balance out. So we usually get what the commission wants to do and use that to estimate tax revenue. And hopefully we come pretty close. I think we've gotten as close as 36,000 a year. Just a couple of things to keep in mind though. Just because you change the millage rate doesn't mean you don't have to advertise tax increase. There's a crazy formula that state uses. You may have to advertise tax increase even if your millage is lower. And just because it's not changing the millage doesn't mean somebody's not going to get the property tax. The next couple charts just compare the general fund from 2013 budget to 2012. The red numbers in red are 2012's numbers, and this breaks down your revenues and where those come from. 87.5% of your revenues come from taxes. That's not all property taxes. And to remember, when you're trying to compare percentages from year to year, the size of the pie, basically, that's not always an exact comparison. But it just kind of gives you an idea from your delivery statement. If you take that 86.5% and break it down between your tax revenues, 67% of that is from property taxes. Your local option sales tax is about 32% of that. And so if you just look at those two, that local option sales tax is really about a third of the property tax from the homeowner. If you look at expenditures by function, general government is about 23%, the judicial is just under 11%. Your biggest expenditure in the general fund is public safety, that's primarily the sheriff's department. The animal control board and emergency management are in there as well, so as little as any of those.
Public safety, EMS, animal control, share, jail.
Jail.
And what else would you say?
Emergency management.
Emergency management. EMS.
And then you see there's other percentages there, very small. The two largest changes you see are the culture and recreation and the housing and development, and as you know, I talked about earlier, the Parks and Rec Authority and the Industrial Authority, and you can count the expenditure fund. If you write down the same expenditures by the type of expenditure, personnel is just under half of that. And then your contractual services, utilities, and things like that make up the bulk of the rest of it. Supplies make up a very small percentage. Capital outlay is very small right now because it's a very, very limited capital outlay. And you have a very small percentage of that service. If you look at your history, at revenues and expenditures on page 16, as well as the fund balance, you see the dip there between 2008 and the increases back in 2012. That is where the technologists came in for the Parks and Rec and Industrial Authority, and they were not included in the general fund, and then we have to change where we're required to show those again, so those can be and it's very hard to see that there is actually a revenue line there. The last several years, it's just very, very, very close to the expenditure line. So the budgets have been very, very tight the last couple of years. Just some of the revenues and expenditures, we went down here to show some of the trends on these. If you look at the property taxes, and you'll see that the comparison of what's levied and what's collected is very, very close. I think on average, the tax commissioner collects between 92% and 95% in the first year. And these are first year numbers only. But you see, up until 2008, there was pretty steady growth in property taxes every year, and that usually is used to fund those increases every year. After 2008, it has been pretty much flat since then. Yes, we are. Instead of declining. Some of those other taxes and intangibles fell off again in 2008 and have not increased any. Real estate transfers as well. Although in 2012, real estate transfers actually increased a very small amount. Those are other property,
I think what we're seeing is the economy is just adjusted to a new normal. I really think that's what we're seeing. I think the new normal is high unemployment, the new normal. So I think it'll probably remain flat, but I think what you see is people kind of settled into the realities.
Again, on page 20, you see the local option sales tax. You saw an increase in that every year, and then it dropped off again in 2008. And it remains relatively flat. It is showing a little bit up between 2012 and 2011. And we are seeing a little bit of increase in 2012. 2013. Prisoner housing is kind of up and down. Right now it is down. It depends on general population as well as where the inmates come from, how much they're paying. Whether they're state inmates or on which city or county.
We have the city of Austin and Eccles County in the state, if they did. We don't have a Lanier or Clinch.
We did at one point, but there may be situations where we would swap if we have an inmate that is somehow related in any way to law enforcement or jail, et cetera. Civil agreement or whatever, and so we may take one of their inmates and that takes a lot of force here to focus. I've been informed by the sheriff that he is notifying those communities that are housing inmates and he would be going up on the
Animal shelter revenues are up slightly, but you'll see in the minutes the expenditures are also up. That's fascinating. State court funds. We've seen for the last couple of years where that dropped off from last year to 2006 and never went back up to 2012 after that. But it's not where it was, but it's actually improving. But if you look at the Superior Court funds, they're going down.
Any they're just not levying fines or not collecting fines?
Well, you know, when we meet with the judges, with the state court magistrate, et cetera, we go over those issues with them, but as far as we have any specific reason, I'm not doing this. Education